In this video, we'll walk through branching your repository with Copia and merging two branches with a code review. If you haven't watched the previous Getting Started videos, you should do so before continuing. A branched workflow makes it easy for multiple engineers to work on the same project concurrently and to manage the development of modular parts of the control logic. To create a new branch, click the Branches menu from Copia's desktop app, then click New Branch. Give your branch a name describing what you'll be working on in this branch. Now, any commits you make are tracked independently from the main branch. Switching back to the main branch, or any other branch, immediately resets your repository to the most recent commit in that branch. Note that you may have to close out of your development environment to allow Copia to modify your files when changing branches. If you change branches with your development environment open, you may see unexpected changes to your files under the Changes tab in the desktop app. If this happens, close your development environment and simply right-click the changes and select Discard Changes. Your files will now match the selected branch and you can continue working normally. To pull changes from one branch into another, you want to create a pull request, which acts as a space for a code review when merging code. Click the Create Pull Request button from the desktop app, select the branch you want to merge your changes into, and the branch you want to pull changes from. As long as there's at least one new commit to pull, you can merge any branch into any other branch. You can see all the differences between the two branches you have selected rendered in aggregate before creating the pull request. When creating a pull request, the pull request name and description are populated with information from the pull from branch. You can modify these to more accurately describe all of the changes in this pull request. Once you create the pull request, you can invite reviewers who will be notified by email of the invitation. The Commits tab shows a list of all commits in this pull request, and the Files for Review tab shows those commits rendered in bulk. From here, you can leave comments on individual tags, lines of structured text, and rungs of ladder logic, allowing for a detailed conversation between the reviewers and the reviewee about specific parts of the control logic up for review. Along with leaving comments on the code itself, you can leave a comment on the entire pull request. Along with the option to comment, reviewers are given the option to approve a pull request or request additional changes to it. Back on the Conversation tab, all of these comments are listed sequentially, allowing you to easily see all code comments, pull request comments, approvals, requests for change, and invitations to review in the order they occurred. Once your code is reviewed, you can merge your branches. If there are changes to the same parts of the control logic on both branches, Copia automatically detects this and requests that you manually decide which version should take priority and end up in the final merged code. From Copia's Merge Conflict tool, select each conflict to view both versions. You can select which version to use for each individual conflict, or you can use either branch to resolve the conflicts in bulk. Once you've resolved all of the conflicts, you can merge the changes, and back on the pull requests page, you can complete the merge and close out the pull request. Now there should be a new commit on the branch you merged your changes into, indicating that the merge was completed. As always, if you run into any problems following along with this workflow, leave us a message in the chat dialog box on the web app and we'll connect with you to help.